Till now we have seen the concepts, core concepts regarding stack. In this particular video, we are going to see lot of applications of the stack, which I have stated here. Now I will go and explain each and every application, and I am sure that by the end of the video, you are going to get complete applications. Like, you don't have any doubt. You will not have any doubt that I am having assurance. Now see the first application of the stack, balancing of symbols. Normally, we evaluate the expressions in the computer. Let us take a simple expression like this, A plus B. Normally, this is an expression which is given for evaluation. Compiler is one thing will be there. This regarding compiler, I have discussed in the C videos. If you don't know about this, you can watch it there. Now, there will be a compiler. Compiler will take care of all these expressions. First, it will scan each and every symbol, and it will make sure that there is no missing of symbols is there. I will explain. Now it will scan each and every symbol, like it is starting from this, and it keep on scanning, and it will maintain a stack. Whenever it encounters open bracket, open parenthesis, it pushes into the stack. Okay, now this is pushed into the stack. Now compiler will come here. Whenever it finds operands or operator, here A, B, C are operand, plus, minus, into are operators, it will just ignore. Now it will scan here, it will see it is a plus, it will ignore. Comes here, B, it is ignore. Then it will seize this closing parenthesis and it will push it. Then whenever it finds matching bracket for the opening bracket, means whenever it finds closing bracket with respect to the opening bracket, it will pop both of them. Now at this instance our stack is empty. At this instance our stack is empty. Now we reached at the end of the symbol, end of the expression, and we got empty stack. Then we can say it as balanced. This expression is called balanced. Suppose I will take another expression very fastly. Now this is the expression, by mistakenly or somehow I didn't put closing bracket. Now what will happen? This is the stack. Now I put this symbol scan, I put this open bracket, and it will ignore this, it will ignore, and we reach it at the end of the expression. Now we find some symbols in the stack. We find some symbols, that is open bracket, in the stack. This is unbalanced. Unbalanced. You saw the magic, right? So for the expression to say it is balanced or unbalanced, we are using the stack. You got it right? Now coming to second example, infix to postfix. Normally we have these kind of expressions like infix expression, prefix expression, postfix expression. Now coming to infix expression, infix expression means the operator will be in the middle, operands will be on both sides of the operator. Coming to prefix, operator will be in the beginning, then operands. Coming to postfix, operator will be at the end. Don't worry about this, we are going to study in detail, but as of now just remember, in the infix, operator will be at the center, in prefix, operator will be at the beginning, in postfix, operator will be at the end. Just like that you remember. Normally how to remember these two things is, normally in a prepaid mobile like Jio or whatever, we are first recharging, then we are using the facilities. Whereas in the postfix like BSNL and all, we use that for month, then at last we will pay. So we use that for month and at last we will pay the bill. Like this is normal, like random thing. You can remember however you are comfortable. This is how I remembered when I studied this. We do recharge first. So prefix, the operator will be at the beginning. Okay. Then in the postfix, operator will be at the end. Somehow you just remember. So these are the things. And we need to convert from infix to prefix, infix to postfix, vice versa. We use stack data structure, that I will tell. Okay. Now evaluation of postfix. This is also one of the best example for application of the stack. Now I am taking one expression, 2 into 3. What is this value? Without any second delay, you will say the answer 6. Why? Because doing this kind of expression, evaluating this, it is very easy for us. But For the computer, it is a dumb machine. It knows only one thing. It knows only this. What is this? This is also same. Value is 6. But it evaluates only in postfix. Why? Because, see, normally we are people from different states like Andhra Pradesh, Tamil Nadu, Karnataka likewise. For the people of Tamil Nadu, they are familiar with Tamil. For the people of Andhra, they are familiar with Telugu. For the people in north part like UP, MP, they are familiar with Hindi. Why? Because their language is very native there. Likewise, for compiler, postfix is very native to it and it is very easy for that to evaluation. Moreover, this is taken by the compiler, but it is very easy. That also we are going to see evaluation of postfix by using stack. Now recursion. Recursion. I will take a duster just a second. Recursion is also one of the main application of the stack. What is meant by recursion is any function which calls itself is called a recursion. Suppose I am taking 5 factorial. 5 factorial. For finding 5 factorial, I need to find 5 into 4 factorial. For 4 factorial, I need to find 4 into 3 factorial. For 3 factorial, I need to find 3 into 2 factorial. For 2 factorial, 2 into 1 factorial. Since we know the value of 1 factorial is 1, it will return here and it will compute 2 into 1 is 2. So 2 factorial value will be completely returned here. Then this complete value will be returned here. So 4 into 3 factorial. Then this complete value will be returned here. Such that 5 factorial we get 120. Okay, I'll take a stack and I will explain you. For finding 5 factorial, we need to find 5 into 4 factorial. So we need to find 5 into 4 factorial. For finding 4 factorial, we need to find 4 into 3 factorial. So 3 factorial. Then it will result the 3 factorial value to here. Then it will return the 4 factorial value to here. Finally in the stack, we will be having 120. So this final 120 value will be returned. Okay, I will explain this much more in the next videos. Okay, now coming to the browser. This is like nowadays each and everyone using mobile phone, laptop or iPad where they used to browse the things in the internet. Normally suppose this is the address bar where we will having URL. Always whatever the address we are visited or whatever the pages we are visited, it will always store in the form of a stack like this. Suppose this is page 1 we visited now. Again we move to second page we visited. Again we move to third page. Okay, suppose first we entered Google, then from that Google we entered to Amazon website. In the Amazon we searching some OnePlus 6 mobile. Okay, OnePlus 6 mobile. Now this is the last visited page which is on the top of the stack. Now if you press back button, immediately it will go to the back page P2. If you hit again back button, it will go to P1. So whatever the pages you are visiting today, whatever the pages you are visited yesterday, last 7 days, last 30 days, it will be stored in the form of a stack. Okay, just an example which you can relate with your daily life. Okay, mostly people will erase the history because they don't want to be caught when anyone sees his history. Okay, now another example is application is text editor. Normally whenever you are typing a document, you keep on typing that. Suppose by mistakenly you have done any wrong spelling, you press Ctrl+Z. Ctrl+Z for undo option, where it will revert back to the previous instance. Then you can keep on typing. So this undo, redo options is best example for stack. Whatever the words you are typing, you keep on pushing onto the stack. Whenever you press Ctrl+Z, the last safe instance will be there. So this undo, redo in text editor is also application of stack. Hope you understand these examples like applications and you understand this video. For more videos, keep watching my channel. I will be posting more videos related to data structure.